riding from the south side, so we looking all around. He's an outlaw, loose and running, came a whisper from his lips, and he's here to do some business with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24. And the notches on his pistol numbered one in 19 more. One in 19 more. Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. Was an Arizona Ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. Came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. He said it didn't mean it. He was after Texas Red. After Texas Red. Was long before the story was related to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry, men they tried before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a slip. One would be the ranger with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 20 past 11 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. And they knew this handsome stranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to meet the play. And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today. Texas Red had not clear leather for a bullet fairly weak. And the ranger's aim was deadly with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was over in a moment and the boys sat back down. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip. When he tried to match the ranger with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Big iron, when he tried to match the ranger with a big iron on his hip. Thank you very much. Thank you, Marcine and Tina. Thank you.